What you are looking at is surprisingly not footage taken of Hawaii's Kilauea volcano, as instead, this clip displays the last eruption of the single most active volcano in the entire Atlantic Ocean, a complex known as Pico de Fogo. Since record-keeping on the island began around 1490, this volcano has erupted 27 times, including a single eruption which lasted for a whopping 261 years in length, where the volcano emitted intermittent Strombolian explosions between 1500 and 1761. Looking at this towering peak and observing that it is located within a horseshoe-shaped crater, you can tell that something catastrophic once occurred here, especially since it has a similar shape to Mount St. Helens after its 1980 eruption. And the reason is that there used to be a much taller shield volcano in its place, which may have once towered to a height of 3,580 meters or 11,745 feet as little as 100,000 years ago. Yet, this peak would partially collapse to the east in a massive landslide. Before we discuss this ancient cataclysm, let us discuss why Cape Verde's island of Fogo used to have the tallest peak in the Atlantic Ocean. The answer is that just like the Hawaiian Islands, the Cape Verde Islands exist due to an unusually hot patch of the upper mantle in what is referred to as a hotspot. This hotspot is thus referred to as the Cape Verde hotspot, and over the last 20 million years, it has created 10 separate volcanic islands, of which only two are potentially still active. Volcanism, which began creating the island of Fogo, started 4.5 million years ago when a volume of basinite lava erupted onto the ocean floor. Over the next 1.3 million years, thousands of overlapping layers of lava from near-continuous eruptions constructed a massive shield volcano that towered 3,500 meters or 11,483 feet from the ocean floor. Finally reaching the surface 3.2 million years ago, the explosive interaction of shallow lava with seawater formed a thin ash plateau. This plateau acted as a base which future eruptions would build the island upon. Over the next 3.1 million years, a Galapagos-like shield volcano was constructed via the eruption of several hundred cubic kilometers of lava, which erupted not only from its summit crater, but also flank vents. However, by 73,000 years ago, the eastern flank of this towering peak, which may have even had snow at times, had become unstable, and soon would trigger a catastrophic collapse. When the landslide began, what likely started as a moderate-sized event within a few dozen seconds propagated to include the entire eastern side of the volcano. As between 130 and 160 cubic kilometers of material slid at a speed of several hundred miles per hour, it may have even triggered a volcanic eruption. Hitting the water and traveling up to 25 kilometers along the seafloor, the slide displaced large volumes of water, generating a towering megatsunami. This tsunami also pushed upwards and carved away at the seafloor, pushing up large boulders that would be carried by the generated tsunami. Upon reaching the northern tip of Santiago Island, the tsunami had a maximum run-up of 270 meters, towering dozens of meters over much of the northern plateau and depositing multi-ton boulders hundreds of meters inland. After a cessation of eruptive activity for 10,000 years, a new vent popped up within the collapse scar, and the eruptions it produced were more explosive. This marked the point when the modern Pico de Fogo volcano began to grow and the shield volcano transitioned to a stratovolcano. In the 63,000 years since, dominantly Strombolian eruptions, which have thrown bombs of lava and deposited ash around its central vent, have built a towering and steep volcanic cone with a gray color. Cinder cones have also formed within and outside the collapse scar since then, erupting in a similar Strombolian manner. However, since 1490, not a single eruption has originated from a flank vent outside of the area affected by the 73,000-year-old collapse, although the presence of five fresh-looking lava flows on the island suggests that such eruptions are likely to occur again in the future. While most of Fogo's eruptions have occurred from its summit crater, this peak has surprisingly not physically erupted since 1799. Instead, every eruption since then has occurred from flank vents, albeit still within the 73,000-year-old collapse scar. These flank vents have erupted at a rate of about once every 25 years, with the last three eruptions occurring in 1951, 1995, and from 2014 to 2015. During eruptions, lava flows have historically been Fogo's main threat, as they have the potential to and have destroyed structures not only within the collapse scar, but also on the eastern flank of this fascinating volcanic island. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.